Welcome to another edition of Arts in Review. This is Julio Martinez, your host for KPFK 90.7 FM. You're listening to us live streamed over the internet over at kpfk.org. Well, Joelle Argueros has been interviewed here in the past, but she brought a brand new project. When you first explained this project to me over the phone, which is a video project, documentary project, you spilled out a lot of words like you usually do, but I was able to grab on to two of them, Michael Jackson. This is a documentary project in relationship to Michael Jackson.
Yes,
but
yes.
But it's not focused on his life.
No.
What was the chronology of all of this? Who originated the concept of doing this?
Well, it was a couple weeks after Michael Jackson died, and I was driving on Laurel Canyon, and I saw this car, and it was covered with Michael Jackson lyrics. And there was a girl, and she was driving, and she had on a white glove. And she was sticking her hand out the window, doing the peace sign the whole time up and down Laurel Canyon. And I was just fascinated because it's someone who was really devoted to Michael Jackson that would put on this glove and put lyrics all over her car. And I was actually on my way to go see Joelle, and I got there and I told Joelle, and Joelle was like, "Oh my God." And what did you say?
I said, "We gotta film this." So that's kind of what motivated everything. When he died, if you live in Los Angeles, it was overwhelming. Hollywood Boulevard was packed by his star. You see a van that's got lyrics all over it. There are people crying in the streets. And then we found out this is happening everywhere. People were just pouring their hearts out in such an intense way that we just felt like we really wanted to capture this love where people from all ages, all races were coming together to show their love for a man. A lot of them were fans we learned after he passed away. They didn't even like him beforehand. We have learned so much about the human condition through these people.
We've heard from celebrities and we've heard from the media and we've heard from every other element of, you know, his industry, except for his fans. So what we did was, is we had an open call at the Stella Adler Theater down in Hollywood where any Michael Jackson fans could come down and share their stories with us. We set up a website that anyone could go to and type their comments and praise or support of Michael. And then we also focused on a few of the individuals that we found initially and did more in-depth stories on their lives as fans and have different perspectives on what it meant to all these different people.
So the documentary, you're chronicling the way people have reacted as fans of Michael Jackson since his death?
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
So hence the title of this project, The Way He Makes Them Feel.
Yes.
Monumental thing that people can only dream of.
He definitely opened a lot of doors for minorities.
People all over the world loved him.
He loved the world.
He transcended color. He transcended everything.
In shocking news today, Michael Jackson pronounced dead at 2:26 Pacific Standard Time.
I was sleeping and I woke up and I kept tossing and turning and I got all these emails and text messages saying he died and I was like, what are you talking about?
I couldn't believe it. I thought someone told me at work and I thought they were joking, so I didn't believe it.
Immediately when we found out, I got my sons and my daughter together and ran to the hospital.
I cried pretty much all day and thinking about
any past and stuff.
Word is fans are already gathering outside the UCLA Medical Center and at the Jackson family home in Encino.
Thursday afternoon, I was standing out in the parking lot and one of my coworkers came downstairs and told me that Michael Jackson had passed away. When I was a little girl, the Tiger Beat magazines, the pictures were all over my room, and that's when it penetrated my heart that somebody that's been part of my life has died. So Friday morning, I made sure I came to work early, and the first thing I did was park my car here in the parking lot, and I walked up to the house.
She came into my office and asked me to go up there, and something within me, I didn't want to go. I really didn't want to go, but I said, sure. She brought me up this street here. A barrage, there was media, there was cameramen. The street was closed. CNN, ABC.
International media, there was local media, there was CNN was directly across the street. All you saw was an outpouring of posters, balloons, flowers, greeting cards, fans. We met fans from all over the world.
And I saw the people, and I saw the connection, and I felt standing next to me, this a friend of mine, I started bawling. People flew in from Japan. People were shaking with sadness.
It was very, very emotional, very surreal.
Everyone was really upset when he passed away, and just as much of a fan base in the UK as it does have here.
I was in the UK and it was absolutely amazing just what happened over there in terms of people taking to the streets, like national week of mourning, not a day of mourning, a national week of mourning. And that may have rolled into a month for some people, but it certainly was an amazing catalyst of love and international support for a gentleman who'd supplied so much entertainment, love and support, I guess, in some way to a myriad of people.
I was really sad. I almost cried. I'm not a kind of person who cries a lot, and I had one tear in my eye. Well, so that day was the really saddest day of my life. Yeah. So.
It was horrible. It's a friend who called us on telephone very early on the morning, and they said us Michael is dead. We don't believe it. We didn't believe it, and we pushed on the TV. And it was a tragedy. We cried, and today we don't believe it. It's incredible. We can't believe that it's true. It's horrible. We love him.
When I saw not only the people gathering at the hospital, and then especially later when people followed to the coroner's office, I realized that this was a profound collective experience that we have all shared of a love of an artist.
It was like a childhood friend or a family member. I felt like I knew him just that well.
This horrible thing happened to him. You know, old people were bringing flowers to the American embassy. Like, yes. Even the whole Russia was sad about Michael Jackson.
I was just like, oh. I actually ended up failing my test for my class. And I was just like, this is the worst day of my life. This, seriously.
It was worse than 9/11 for me, basically. You know, that you can compare it like that. It was really bad for me, actually. Basically, my parents got divorced when I was like really little, so that was really sad for me. And basically, when I listened to Michael's songs, it just cheered me up. So kind of he saved my life.
He died too soon, way too soon.
We just all sat around the table. It was late at night. We had a few drinks and we cried and we reminisced about all his songs.
I crashed like a plane spiraling down. I lost 15 pounds and I had to go to a grief therapist.
We all felt this together and it was awesome. It was awesome. And as the days went on, Sandy and I came up more. We became closer in friendship. And we're very good friends now, brought together because of this.
When I get older, I'm sure I will always listen to his music. I mean, no matter where we go, we always have Michael Jackson music in. I know that when I'm older, it'll probably be harder to like think about that I was actually went to the house when, you know, after it had happened.
I was one of those people that threw Michael Jackson under the bus. I allowed the media to affect me, and when he started changing and in his adult years and his huge popularity, I had turned my back on Michael Jackson.
When did I first fall in love with Michael? Recently.
This man gave more, had a purer heart than anybody, donated more money, was so pure in his doing, and look what I allowed the media to do to my heart.
So many celebrities have died in the past, and it's like, okay, so they're gone. But as I watched the news, and I saw the global grief all over the world, I started thinking, what is it with this man that so many are crying so painfully for him?
The thing that I loved most about Michael, he loved the world.
He had such a grand purpose that was so consistent throughout his life to save, heal the world and help children. And he really channeled that into me as a teacher. I must admit I lost a passion for it. And he fueled that in me, that I really want to make that my purpose.
The sense of just silliness in the loss of someone who repeatedly seemed to really only have an interest in everyone else's well-being and entertaining everyone else is so rare that I can't think of anyone other than possible spiritual figures that people follow. And I'm not saying that Michael's a spiritual figure, but someone that has that amount of empathy and love to give, and it touched me.
You asked me a question when we were at the Hollywood Star, and you asked me about the day when I heard the news, and I say this with a lot of regrets and guilt, shame even, and I'm going to start crying, I don't want to do this. I've actually asked Michael to forgive me for this. My daughter and I were home, and they said Michael Jackson was rushed to the hospital from a heart attack. And the first words out of my mouth was, remember Farrah died that morning? He just can't have Farrah have her day.
I was like, why are you crying? I mean, it's sad, and he had kids, but you don't know him. And she's like, well, you have to get to know him. So every time she found out something new about Michael, she'd tell me. And it just warmed its way under my skin, I guess.
Actually, I grew up in the family where my mom considered music noise. So there came a point of time in my life where music was noise to me. In fact, you can ask my daughter, if we're driving and she turns on music, I would have her turn it off because it's distraction to me. So I ran into his music maybe just here and there at parties. So to me, really, I fell in love with Michael as a human being, and falling in love with him as an artist came later on. But now the music doesn't stop and it's all Michael's.
This is gonna sound like blasphemy, but I'm not a big fan of his music. There are a couple songs that I really like, but his music's not my thing.
A lot of people say music died when Michael passed. To me, I discovered music when Michael passed, when I discovered Michael. So to me, music is also one of the gifts that he has given me. And now I look back and I think, how did I ever live my life so long without the joy of music?
It's the humanitarian part of him that really just amazed me.
He knew when to love, he knew when to fight. And a lot of people ignore the fight part of him.
My mom emailed me a list of all the charities he's donated to, all his media appearances for different causes. the amount of money and time and dedication he's put towards making kids better, children's hospitals, making things happen for sick kids, the environment, kids who have been murdered, kids who have been kidnapped, the way he treats his staff, and I'm like, this guy's amazing. I kind of feel like it's so rare these days for someone to genuinely care about a cause without plastering it all over their lives. I mean, whether you've got a friend who just won't shut up about, oh, I'm doing this run, or oh, I'm donating here, or oh, I'm volunteering here, to celebrities who are like, oh, look at my latest trans international adoption, you know? But Michael just does these things, and he doesn't even, the organization has to go out of its way to say, hey, Michael did this for us.
Taking my research, the logic, the reasoning, and what I really saw, I have decided that the world, that time, has lost a brother, a lover, a teacher, probably one of the greatest men of our times. And I began to really look at other aspects of his life as a father, as the way he loves his fans, the way he loves this planet, and how he tried to really call our attention. And there is not a day that has gone by that I haven't seen something new about him. And the more I know about him, the more I get to love him. And so that's how I met Michael Jackson.
I'm positive that a lot of what he's done has contributed to the recovery, genuine recovery of a lot of people.
I don't see Michael just like an entertainer. I see him in the ranks of Martin Luther King Jr., Mother Teresa, Nelson Mandela, Mahatma Gandhi, JFK, a world leader.
My favorite Michael Jackson tune is Gotta Be Dancin', I swear to God, because it's like one of the best dance numbers that anyone can groove to it. People love it. You could hear it 2-3 times a night, and it's like the perfect song to actually get people in the mood to start dancing, I think. Can I do a Michael Jackson move? I can do an incorporated Michael Jackson move. Now, I have sort of a swollen left knee, but basically, of course, he's known for the moonwalk, and we at the club used to do a little thing that was at the Charleston, and he used to do something like this. On Soul Train, more like New Jack Swing. Not bad for 50 years old, is that? I'm not 50, I'm 48, I might as well be.
I always felt, and I know all the Michael fans will say this, I always felt like when I dance like him or when I sing his songs, I almost felt like I was singing with him. Growing up in Haiti, man, it was just like, it was such an amazing sound, because at a time that's all it was, because I didn't know what they were saying. It was just, the sound was so powerful that it would just hit me and it would just motivate me.
Thank you.
every Haitian, I don't care who, every Haitian knows who Michael is. If you grew up in the 80s, to probably till this day, you still know who Michael is. And you always know who Michael is because he was that powerful.
In France, we didn't know the Jackson's Five. I mean, the first time we discovered Michael Jackson was with Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. And at that time, it was, you know, maybe 15 on the chart. And I said, wow, there is something about him. I mean, he should be number one, you know. And sure enough, a few weeks later, he was number one everywhere.
He represented so much what I was about. And I saw him as a great mentor. And pretty much everything he did, I agreed with. And when you see an individual who isn't afraid to be different and is willing to stand up in front of the world and actually speak up on things that need addressing, I am behind that 100%.
Coming here was a big struggle, but at the same time, it was like anybody else that comes to this country, you know, this land of opportunity, and knowing that he's from here, knowing what he's accomplished, especially knowing his story from what he started to where he is now, it's like it gives you so much hope.
In France, they really loved Michael Jackson, and all the generations, you know, my mother, my grandmother loved it. I mean, it was really, they didn't care, you know, because he came from America, they didn't care, you know, because I'm sure you heard about the rumors that France and America, you know, don't have the best relationship.
I came here for my first trial. I was gonna go home at the end of it. You know, that was the plan.
He really influenced me because of his energy.
I went to school and they had a dance. And I didn't know how to dance. I did not know how to dance. Yes, I did not know how to dance. A lot of my friends were like, no. It's not true. And there's a couple friends that know I do not know how to dance. And it was embarrassing. And I remember being at a party and everybody's dancing with girls and stuff like that. And I didn't know what to do. And I'm from Haiti and I'm like all awkward and stuff. My shirt's all buttoned up. And they're like, but shit, man, just jump behind him, man. Just dance. And I'm like, all right. And I look like a fool. And everybody started laughing. I was like, oh, man. And then they played Michael. And everybody saw me do that due to Michael. And they were like, oh, snap. Wait a minute, this man could do Michael, but I couldn't do anything else.
He was a real person, and that's why he reached everybody. Everybody could connect to him.
There's so much negativity in this world and so much greed that he recognized the platform he had to address the world and actually do good with it rather than just being an entertainer.
One thing about Asian people is just that we're very, very strong and we have a lot of faith and we know how to persevere and move on and still keep our positive self and not let the world bring us down, no matter how much it crumbles, literally, around us. We don't let that stop us from living. And, you know, and that's one thing you could say about Michael, too. No matter how crumble his world was around him, he never stopped loving what he loves to do.
What was my main reason for getting into supporting Michael to the level that I did? And my main reason for that was basically as an escape for me and actually make a difference in this world and make a change. And I know it sounds like a Miss World thing or a cliche, but that's what he was sincerely trying to do, you know? And sadly, the other things that led to, you know, now, you know, over the last 10, 15 years with the accusations and stuff, that took away his platform because people started to ridicule him and not take him seriously.
This man has done monumental things that people can only dream of.
People that have negative anything to say about Michael, they have something wrong in their heart.
If your heart is not open, okay, then you don't like Michael, but you probably don't like puppies and kittens either.
After all the trial and everything, he went back like on his feet, like ready to go.
For the people who are anti-Michael, like to an extent, like I can understand if they're thinking about it in the sense of as far as children go, because like definitely those are some really, really bad accusations. But I think those are also the people that don't realize what he's made an impact on as far as like music and even like having people who are African-American in a positive light, you know what I mean?
You see the love in his eyes and you see the innocence in his heart. And you know, that's what he says isn't what the media wants you to believe.
He just said, okay, you know, I love you, you hurt me, but it's okay. I'm gonna respond by writing a song or doing something special. And that's what he did.
The message behind the song, you know, we are the world. And as much as I didn't know English, but I kind of saw what he was, with the images that he showed, I kind of understood what he was trying to do.
A human being when you love, and Michael was that person. No matter what, he always get back on his feet and love.
I was like, man, with images, I was like, wow, this man is really someone that actually cares about people.
At the end of the day, all he wanted to do was make, you know, all the children in the world stop suffering, and he wanted the world to be peaceful. He wanted the planet to be healthy again, so there wasn't all the problems with the global warming, and, you know, he just wanted to make the world aware, people, everyday people, to be aware that everybody can make that difference.
The Jewish people say a mensch. For me, Michael Jackson was a mensch.
He was so humble. Not once I've ever seen him go out and he was like, psh, I got two of them, baby.
When I was a teenager, I lost my father to cancer. And so I had no dominant male figure in my life after that. My dad was my mentor and the biggest thing in my life. And Michael was the one thing, and I don't even know how it happened, but it's the one thing that really stood out to me at that time that helped me work through it. And it's just so sad that now 12 years later, I've lost him too.
I really miss him, you know, as an inspiring person. I mean, for not only as a performer, but also as a human being.
I was blessed to be alive, both in my dad's presence and in Michael's presence, because I'm me because of them, you know, and I wouldn't change that for the world. And hopefully, you know, I can make the change. My dad taught me a lot, and you know, Michael taught me further about other things in life, and I've managed to change my whole life now being here. And you know, I've got opportunities at my fingertips now that were only dreams once upon a time. So I've only got Michael to thank for that.
My goal is to make sure that I, as a Haitian American, to make sure that I get people to do the same thing that he did, or the same thing that I'm doing, that to make sure that you stay humble and focus on people. Not to make money, not to get earn a paycheck, because I know how much it affects you. And I want to do that.
I love Michael because not only did he inspire us musically, he inspired us as people, because his lyrics, you know, push buttons. You see what I'm saying? The man in the mirror. You see what I'm saying? Who are you looking at?
There's no limit. As long as you have a dream and you have the drive and the talent, that you could accomplish great things. And I think that's personally how he touched me, like to know that I can go after things that seem somewhat impossible, that I know I can do it. And for other people, I'm sure I can relate to that too.
If it wasn't for him, I mean, a lot of today's artists wouldn't exist. So for me, he means a lot, and he will always do.
You know, I came to LA to perform and stuff. And to me, he is the reason I got into performing also, as far as, you know, just that search for perfection, that search for art and beauty.
He has been a part of my family. I feel like he's someone, you know, that I can always count on. I don't know, just the music, everything. For my family especially, my parents are from Ethiopia. He was someone they knew over there too, you know. And my family, there are five of us, and every Christmas we do a Christmas play. And each one of us would take on one of the characters, and it fit so well with our ages and everything. And we danced to his music every year since I was about 3 or 4 years old. And I don't know, it was just such a hard time when he passed for my family. I cried for days, like my own grandmother passed away just about a year ago, and I feel like I cried even harder when Michael passed, just because I feel like I grew up with him.
You are the reason why I love music, and because of you, I have a huge and big heart for everyone on this planet. And through your music and inspiration, I will teach my children.
My thing is, if, like I told the kids, that this is how I get to use them as example, because I love using Michael as example. I said, if he can get down and he can come back up, we can get down and we're gonna rise back up too. You know, I said, just like any American family, they can. I said, but with him, it's something special. This was a home that I can truly say outside of 518, I felt comfortable in. I felt safe in. It wasn't too big. The house wasn't too big and it wasn't too small. It was just right. And the piano would sit right over there in the corner. So I would be able to hear her playing the piano. Christina would go into her room and play the saxophone. Brianna would be either outside in the garage playing a guitar. So it was always something going. Now these two, they're not showing it now, but they would fight. Like cats and dogs, not physically fight, but would argue some. But when it came to Michael Jackson, they would sit down together at that piano. And I'm like, look at that. You know, he even brought them together to where they wouldn't be arguing. Now they're doing little dance routines together. Gary went out on three trips and the truck would break down. And because the truck broke down, the owner decided to pay to get the truck fixed instead of paying him.
Then calling the guy, he won't answer the phone, email, won't answer no emails, he won't do nothing.
So we decided we would just go on, move here, take a step down. And then that's when Shamika, when we got here, she saw it and she says, this house is little. And then so I said, yes, I know. She said, but Michael Jackson and them did it. It was a lot of them in a two-bedroom house. And it's only four of us, so we can do it. I said, four, you mean five. She was just learning how to play piano, and they started getting the chords online. Every day she would come home, she would do her homework, do her chores, just so she can get on that piano and play Michael Jackson songs. She just started to explode with it.
She could take that piano and play it almost like professional. Mm-hmm. For somebody never been taught how to move the hands, you know, it might be not be exact, but it's her thing, you know what I'm saying? And she just sits there and she just goes. And I'm like, dang. And I'm just in the room and I'm just listening and she's just playing and I'm like, wow.
We lost a lot of our instruments, piano, guitar. I think I was the only one that was able to keep something, and that was my flute.
Last thing I wanted to do was put that piano in storage, because normally I would find a place where I can sit the piano. A baby grand, no place for it to go.
His death showed me that our life here on Earth is not gonna last forever, and this is our one shot to do what we have to do. And he's made a very great impact on my life by his music, his singing, his dancing. It just made me, as myself, just want to go out and do more of my thing that I like to do, which is music and dancing.
With Michael Jackson, when he'd go through something in life where he'd see an issue in the world, he'll address it in his songs. And with me, I used to have a lot of like feelings bottled up, and so I would express my feelings through my lyrics. I'm gonna go into tears right now, hold on. But when I realized Michael Jackson did that, was an inspiration for me to do it. It's easier to write than speak it, if that makes sense. So that's the way it is for me. So when I saw him do it, and I kind of figured I should do it too, and I did it, and it helps a lot. It's a good coping mechanism. Preschool, recycle, throw the cans in the gray trash can, you know, recycle, recycle, but it's kind of like that didn't really get to us kids.
Before he sung like the song Earth Song, and before I heard it, I didn't really care about the environment as much as I do now.
Now we're working our way back up and we're here.
We're able to get our instruments back. I have my saxophone back.
I've taught my children, you know, don't look at him as an icon. You know, look at him as a person. He was somebody's son, he was a father, he was a brother. You know, he was a person, and that's what he wanted to be known for. The really strong forces in his life is Janet and his mother. And there's nothing like a mother's love. And his mother is the backbone of everything, just like I'm the backbone of this family.
Behind every man, there's a strong woman. See? And that's my strong woman right there. Because without her, I wouldn't be here today.
I love you for that. Mm-hmm. That's nice. That's awesome. Tell some more stories.
Mm-hmm. Michael Jackson is pretty much my life, you know, and I've been watching him since I was about three and just studying every dance move, every note, and just trying to be just like him. Even though he was like the biggest, like most famous guy in the world, he always had love for like everybody, and he was never too cocky or anything like that. I mean, he's inspired so many people, including me, and I was just like, I'm trying to do exactly what he did, so maybe I can inspire other people too, so.
Michael, thank you for everything you've done for this world. We appreciate your music, and thank you for bringing the world together.
I was about to say what he said, so.
Michael did a lot of humanitarian work, and that's inspired me to, you know, to go and help out, heal the world. That's the thing, heal the world.
I teach my kids what he does, like to help anyone and everyone, and it doesn't matter race, gender, or color. But I mean, he's a beautiful human being, so. This costume that my son has here, he wears it like every single day.
One day I was playing his music about 4 years ago, and my son said, Mom, I love his music. I don't know why, but I just love it. I said, baby, you have literally been listening to his music before you came in this world. When I was in a hospital in labor, the only thing that soothed me was Michael Jackson's voice. I played his music the entire 8 hours I was in labor. He literally came out listening to Michael Jackson music, and I said, that is why you love his music so much.
He was just very unique. You know, when he came out with Billie Jean, it was a new style, it was a new dance, it was a new sound, and he was just totally himself, and he was so comfortable with it that everybody immediately was attracted to it.
My dad and all my uncles, they used to play Michael Jackson in the car everywhere, so I grew up with his music as well. I mean, I'm sure everyone has the same story, but I can't really make anything different. He's inspired everyone.
I don't really dance at all. I don't really go to clubs or anything, but if anything would inspire me to want to do that naturally, it would be Michael's music.
Yeah, I listen to the music almost everywhere. And he make it me so proud, like we are the world. Oh, I love that.
His song, Heal the World, that song just really, I always listen to it when I'm sad, depressed. I'm always like with kids. I love to help kids, and to know that he felt the same way, that really, really connected to me.
It's something, a certain kind of a craftsmanship, you know. He doesn't just perform, he doesn't just draw the lines, he fills the whole space.
I want some of what he had as far as his personality and everything.
You can demand attention, and then you can command attention.
And he just steps on the stage. I mean, he was just like, cha-pow! And you're just like, oh!
I actually had to dance to his songs, and it was just, it was incredible. His moves were just on point to not even the actual beat. It was to the littlest beats ever, and you had to, like, hit that, you know, even that little movement, you had to do it.
Every day I'm on my couch listening to music, and it's Michael Jackson.
Please, he united the world through music. That's who he was. He was music. Michael Jackson was music.
I think I was in kindergarten when Thriller came out. Like, yeah, that's what made me have to go and learn how to dance so I could be in a video with Michael or, you know, Prince or Madonna, you know?
My parents, my family, like, you know, the younger, they grew up with his music. So I grew up listening to him. I listened to his music all the time. Like, no lie, right there. She had a quinceañera like 3 weeks ago.
Yeah,
and they learned the Thriller dance.
My whole life, I have sat by myself pretending to have this interview right now that we're having. No one could do what he can do. And people will try to imitate him like Usher and Neo, but they'll never be able to do what he can do, ever, because he's an original. He created everything from scratch. I mean, he took little things from his roots and stuff and created, you know, what he is, the king of pop, rock, and soul. In my eyes, he's not just the king of pop, he's the king of pop, rock, and soul.
Behind the line.
How do you explain Michael Jackson and Alex? They're just very sweet and kind of have a sheltered feel about them. Innocence. Yeah, it's an innocence about them. And they're so similar in that way. Yeah.
It's strange to me because it's almost like Alex kind of channels Michael Jackson when he performs.
I like Michael Jackson, you know, and he's a god to the music world. Alex doesn't just like Michael Jackson. He's like a part of the family.
I think a lot of Michael Jackson's music is timeless. I don't think it has age to it. I mean, you put Billie Jean on the radio right now, it sounds like it fits in with what's on the radio today.
We love music, and music is our life, and it was so obvious that Michael Jackson's life was about music, too. And I think that he did something that no one else could do, and it's just kind of take care of Alex.
My whole life, I've known who Michael Jackson is, and that I think my sister was a huge fan, and she's 7 years older than I am. And, you know, so, I mean, I'd watch that Thriller VHS tape, you know, over and over again as a kid.
I think the story is his first day of kindergarten, he and, of course, his brother were both there, his wonderful twin Matt, and they came in and said, "I'm here," because they've been waiting for that moment to get there. I first met Alex before he was born when his mother came into his sister's kindergarten class and said, "I'm pregnant with twins." I'm like, "Oh, look."
Two worlds that you see, so sweet.
see will play out how her girl one. And Alex was epic. And he was like kicking.
Kicking.
And I was happy to get a brilliant man. And he kicked.
he was pulling off some moves.
Besides the musical things we do, we'd have these talent shows, and he, you know, and the kids come up with their own things. We don't really direct them. We don't tell them what to do. They come up with their own things. He'd always come up with something Michael Jackson. He'd be playing the guitar. He'd be doing these spins. He'd be, you know, doing the moonwalk, doing all this kind of stuff. And back then, we were always thinking, how does he know these things?
Yeah, Michael Bum. And it had a good song. Yeah. And the jacket.
Hang old jacket.
And his brother. Him. And he put on the music, and he would choreograph. And if he didn't do it right, he would be embarrassed so much. And he would call me.
He wanted to touch his crotch like Michael, but we said, no, you can't do that in kindergarten. So he had to touch his belt. And so it was a real struggle for him to learn to touch his belt, grab his belt, and not, yep, grab the belt. Don't grab the crotch.
When they came out on stage, I fell in my heart.
Yeah.
It was so cute.
Yeah.
And it won.
They won, yeah.
And that's why they were giggling, because they were amazed that people were so into it.
Auditioning in this dance room, and I saw these two twins, and I was like, oh, they're kind of cute. I saw them and didn't realize that they were the boys that my brothers were telling me about before the audition, and then realized that my brother knew them, and Alex's smile just, you know, struck me from the moment I met him, and we ended up having like crush on each other in the beginning of our friendship, and it was really cute, and then ended up just like becoming best friends, and yeah.
Alex wouldn't be the dancer that he is if it wasn't for Michael Jackson. You know, not at all.
I love dancing, and the only type of dancing I do is Michael Jackson. So, I mean, I love doing that, and I think, you know, honestly, I want to continue to do it to keep him alive, you know? To be like, hey, don't forget, he was here and he was incredible.
Captain EO from Disneyland, I mean, literally was our life growing up, and then that just kind of started everything. We were like, you like Michael Jackson? I love Michael Jackson too. So we just started listening to all the CDs, and then I had a bootleg copy of Captain EO, and he like freaked out about it, and then we just turned it on. Like, I think it was like the second night we hung out with each other, we watched Captain EO, all of us together, and it was great. I made him a bootleg copy, you know, he thought I was cool.
When we decided that this room was going to be used more for dancing, there was a need for it because they always were looking for a place to dance and rehearse and practice. And so we hardly ever were using this room.
Hey, look, hot on the carpet when you try to
do the spins. Try to do the spins.
Right. I look on the carpet and I saw wood.
Yeah, that's when we decided that it was time. When he was having a problem doing his turns and stuff from Michael moves on the carpet, well, let's see what's under the carpet. So we pull up the carpet and we find out it's this nice hard wood. This was the place where everybody came to do their dance routines. So we'd have 8 people in here doing dance routines like it was some studio in Hollywood or something. You know? Because, oh, let's go to the Bartoshes. They have that studio, you know?
But I think it's a little
There's tons of scuff marks under the carpet.
I didn't know how good he was of a dancer, actually, until his freshman year of high school.
Our freshman year, he decided he wanted to enter the talent competition by himself alone.
For weeks and weeks and who knows how long, our Alex would be in his bedroom playing, blaring Michael Jackson music, and I thought he was just chilling out there enjoying the music.
Like, he would be in his room for hours and he'd come out all sweaty, but we didn't know, you know, what he was doing in there.
Moving furniture.
Yeah.
And we
had moving furniture around in there. What is he doing in there? And this went on for a long time, but we just, you know, we were parents out here and they were teenagers in there and whatever, you know, let them play their music.
You know, I'd lock myself in my room and I would, you know, there'd be a mirror and I would practice and practice and practice. And you're like, no, this isn't good enough yet. I can't show anybody this. So I'd wait, you know. And I started dancing for, like, you know, 3 months in my room. And then I finally was like, okay, I think I'm ready to show my sister and my brother. So I called him in. I was like, okay, I just want to show you guys something real fast. Press play on when I point to you.
He sat me down in the living room and said, I want to show you something. I was like, what is this about? And he starts playing Michael Jackson music. I'm like, what are you going to do?
We were just going, okay, he's gonna do Michael Jackson dancing?
I'm a banger.
There was a senior who was like, he was actually half black, I think, and he was like the Michael Jackson guy of the school. And he had done his whole Michael Jackson spiel for the talent show. So Alex is all nervous because he's last. He goes on and he blew everybody away. Like, I couldn't believe it. Like, I had chills and I was like, how is he doing this? The entire place just like erupts as he's like doing like these like isolation tricks and everything. And
the crowd, literally, I can't even tell you, the crowd went insane. He did it right after the senior did it.
I was blown away. It freaked me out. It was honestly, it was like not him. It was like someone, it was Michael Jackson. I was like, how did you learn how to do this? What have you been, that's what I've been doing in my room. That's what all that noise was.
By the end of it, you had seniors on the side walls going like this, and he's a freshman, and these people were just like bowing to him because he just knocked the socks off it. I'm recording and I'm starting to scream. I go, yeah, you know, because where did this come from?
Then they did this this battle between the two Michael Jacksons, and the other kid was just like, he only had a few moves, and Alex was like helping him out. He's like, hey, do this one, you know. So Alex, from then on, in the community, was like Michael Jackson.
I was so proud.
We were just busting. It was one of the most proud moments of my life.
I don't think without Michael, either one of us would be where we are today.
About half a year ago, I was addicted to heroin, and I was for a while. And Gretchen came to me, my best friend Gretchen, and said, hey, we want to do this Michael Jackson show.
We ended up doing this tribute show for him in October.
In a sense, Michael kind of saved my life, because I'd still be using today if it wasn't for that show. And at that time, of everything that happened, it kind of worked out and placed out perfectly.
It was our little closure and goodbye to him, you know. It felt really good because Alex and I didn't dance together for 4 years. To get to do that together on stage for the person who brought us together in the first place was just really awesome.
I'm over it, I don't ever want to touch it again, I know I can't control it, and so I kind of owe Gretchen and Michael that kind of gratitude for getting me through that. My mom has been really incredible. You know, she was, you know, when she, Because she was very supportive.
Love each other.
Yeah.
Help each other.
And this man.
Loved each other and helped each other.
Hope is everything.
Hope is everything.
I didn't really know what that word meant.
Right.
I know I had and they told me there was no hope.
Mm-hmm.
But that's never true.
Right.
There's always my hope. Oh, God, she's near.
We're all, like I was saying before, we're all realizing that, okay, every day we need to ask Mom, what can I do for you? You know, because it's quality of life now, every day. And because we don't know what quantity is left.
I can't be musical anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But I get a lot of joy working and perform. And, you know, it's okay.
A singer, I'm a hip-hop artist, but I incorporate the foundation that Michael laid for us into my hip-hop music. So to me, he's always going to be not just the king of pop, but he's the king himself.
You know, you have to remember how good this person was, how much he gave to charity, how much love he gave to everyone.
He was the man. He always, I mean, everything that you want to dance to and you hear, you can't not hear Michael and want to move. You've got to, even if you're, you know, churchy and conservative, you've got to want to move to Michael.
How many people has given, you know, their own money to help other people? Michael did that out of his own pocket, you know. How many artists do that, you know? They have some a sponsor or something doing that, but he did it out of his pocket, you know. And that's what made him human, a humanitarian. He loved everybody.
I'm mainly a painter, and I got inspired to do a piece of artwork that was a different sort of media. And I was walking through the grocery store one day, and I noticed that cans were, you know, coming basically all the colors of the rainbow. And I thought, you know, I haven't really seen something made out of cans. So that was kind of how it started. And then I knew that I had to get somebody that was a public figure, recognizable. And I thought, well, maybe a political figure or George Washington or something. But it's like, nah. And then I came across the idea of Michael Jackson. I was like, that's a good idea. And nobody had done much fine art related to Michael Jackson. So I was like, wow, it's perfect. You know, and he really should be in fine art, right? You know, I've done a lot of painting. But I actually learned about painting in doing this because, you know, it's in six pieces. And I have it in my living room floor, which, much to my wife's dismay, And so I got cans all over, right? And, you know, so I'm bent over, putting the cans down, and, you know, there was a picture I was working from, obviously, and I'm just trying to match the color of the cans to the part I'm working on, and it was a lot like having a palette of paint, and that's kind of how it went. And then later on, after I'm driving down the road, it hit me that his nickname is the King of Pop. And I'm like, wait a second, this is perfect, you know? And a beam of light came down from the clouds. And... yeah, I've been a fan of his for years. I grew up in the 80s, and you can't not be influenced by the guy.
Where are you from?
Ada, Oklahoma.
From Washington, D.C.
Houston, Texas.
New Mexico, Albuquerque.
New York.
Virginia.
Jacksonville, Florida.
Los Angeles, California.
I'm from England.
I'm from Adelaide, Australia.
Did you come all this way to see the star today?
Yes, I did.
Did you come all this way today to see Michael Jackson?
I did, yes. Yes. I had to be here for the first anniversary.
He's just such a sweet person.
Mike made me look at myself. You know, we all have come from making mistakes. And it was good to have individuals like Mike in the world, you know, because they help you overcome those mistakes. They help you to see who you really are.
I knew he was loved, but I didn't know how much he was loved. Sometimes you don't know what you have until you lose it. And if we had known what we know now, we would have taken better care of him.
I've been the only one, you know, keeping him going, keeping him alive. And I'm finding out that I am not. He's still here. He's with us. He's in my heart. He will be in my heart forever. I'm not going to let him go.
Que en un rincón de este mundo había una mujer que te amaba, que siempre te amó desde pequeña, desde bebé.
Michael, you are a very good person, and I love you with all my heart, and
if he hadn't had the care for the world that he had, like, you'd be sad, like someone else would die, but you'd get over it, like everyone keeps telling us to do, get over it, get over it. It's been a year. But he touches your heart.
Everybody thinks I'm crazy. My mom was like, please go get it out of your system. I'm like, you can't. He's part of my spirit. You can't get rid of a part of you, you know? He's gone, but he's not. He'll never be gone until, it's for me, until I'm gone. he was a special person. I don't think we'll ever have a person like that again. And if we do, I hope we treat them better, you know? I hope we do.
All of us feel him in our lives even more than we ever did as a spirit, but all of us wish he were back here as a person.
I was in a car accident, and he was basically my therapy when I came home. And I really didn't need any therapy because I would watch Michael's and Janet's videos and I would try to learn their dance steps, and that was physical therapy for me. I didn't even know I was doing physical therapy.
I am here to celebrate the life of Michael Jackson, not mourn his death. I'm very pleased that we had him here for 50 long years and he produced a massive amount of material which we could never get tired of.
I'm really happy to be here because we get to be here with everybody else who really misses him and still thinks about him.
I like Michael Jackson because he's the best guy ever.
Obviously, physically he's gone, but mentally we can still feel him. I mean, look, you can see behind you, look, this blue Venus, it's 4 o'clock and it's still happening. It's still going on. No one wants to give up, no one's tired, everyone's dancing. His spirit is among us, his spirit will stay among us, and we will live it forever and ever.
I think this is going to go on for a long time. I don't... He may be here for days.
I'm exciting, I'm happy.
He made me, like, believe that I could do anything that I wanted to.
Thank you, Michael. I love you so much.
This is exactly what he wants. Gathering and love each other, our races, you know, no religion, no race, no color of skin. The human is everyone's same.
I mean, even if you look in the circle and anywhere, you look at pictures of its past concerts, it's people of all different races, ethnicities, religions, it makes no difference. Michael transcends, his genuine love transcends all barriers that people normally put up.
This time of like wars and division, Michael was a very unifying force for people from all over the world.
I'll keep him in my heart every day. I listen to his music. I turn my room into Neverland. I have his name tattooed on me. I love this man. This is like the man.
It's a happy thing. I'm glad that everybody, you know, is still remembering his name and still singing his music and dressing like him. Everybody says it, but it's the truth. I started because of Michael, and he's a big inspiration to me, and I think it's amazing how he influenced the whole world.
People called him a freak. People called him different. People said he wasn't doing it the right way. But he did it the right way. He did it his way. And when you go by faith, again, success will follow. Thank you, Michael, because now I know when faith is undeniable, your success is inevitable.
I was here last year. I was here this year. So next year could be the same thing.
I was just telling my fiance, if I could have married him, I would have married him.
Woo-hoo! We know that everyone is moonwalking with you in heaven, and you're probably throwing a party up there.
I came here to celebrate the life of Michael Jackson.
He's the greatest entertainer that ever lived. He's the best.
He's just such a sweet person.
I miss Michael Jackson. His performance,
I just love him.
Significance to, you know, how he touched so many.
He made me change my life to help homeless people.
He has this magic about him that I can't even.
It's a happy thing. I'm glad that everybody. I'm great for his
kids. That he was a big influence on music everywhere, and a great person too.
Thank you.
Michael Jackson, you are not going nowhere. You are here. You're not leaving this earth. You're not going nowhere. I don't care what people say about you. I don't care if they're criticizing you for what you did. You will be here. You put this here. If it hadn't been for your music, we wouldn't be here. We will not be here today.
Amen.
If it hasn't been for you, we wouldn't be here. And if it wasn't for your career and your music, you wouldn't be here either.